Hello, hello! Today, in this video, I want to show you a really useful project. A few days ago, I was cleaning up and found my old Raspberry Pi together with a bunch of hard drives. I don't know about you, but to me that sounds like the perfect setup for building a NAS. Now, before we get started, let's talk about what a NAS actually is and why it's such a great solution. A NAS, Network Attached Storage, lets you store and access files from any device on your network, making it a perfect way to repurpose old hardware. You can have access to the same file from a different computer, and that's awesome. If you have an old laptop or even a Raspberry Pi just like me with 1 GB of RAM or of course more and some hard drives, you can easily turn them into a fully functional home NAS. In this video, I will show you how to transfer this teeny device or old laptop into a powerful network storage system using OpenMediaVault. I also found a really cool NAS case that looks amazing. For now, I'm just testing the setup, but who knows? Maybe in the future, I will expand this project with more hard drives and dedicated SATA controller. If you are looking for a cheap and easy way to reuse old components and get extra storage accessible from any device on your network, stay with me. I will walk you through everything, step by step, from installation to configuration and file sharing. Let's get started! I will start by creating a system on the SD card. If you already have the system installed on your device, you can move on to the next step. To save the system on the SD card, I will use the Raspberry Pi imager from raspberrypi.com. By the way, you will find all the links in the description and after some time also on my blog. So, Raspberry Pi imager, choose device, I choose Raspberry Pi 3, operating system, other, and Raspberry Pi OS Little 64-bit, storage, my SD card. Now you can edit settings, you can set the hostname, username, password, and of course configure the Wi-Fi. In services you should enable SSH, and I use just password and authentication. But you can allow public key authentication on, and this is for options. And save. Yes. Yes. And this can take some time, so you can go for a coffee. Okay, now we can put everything together and turn on new home, local and cheap NAS server. As I mentioned, this time I'm not printing any Raspberry Pi case on 3D printer, but who knows, maybe in the future I will print something cool. Now I will use my old case, which I bought a long time ago. I think it's still cool. As you can see, this case contains only old hard drive and small electronic board. I have more old unused disks, so my project can grow. Now let's connect just one. Okay, let's connect it here. Now the power cable. And after a while, the LED should light up. Okay, now we can go to OpenMediaVault, requirements. 1 GB of RAM is minimal, but recommended is 8 GB. Okay, and go back to OpenMediaVault. And this is installation guide for the Debian. I also add the link in the description. We just can copy this. Okay, now I can connect to my Raspberry Pi, SSH, Raspberry, and my IP address. Password. And all the commands should be run as root So sudo su, okay, and paste. The next one, copy, paste, enter, and again, copy, paste, and of course this can take some time, so let's speed up the recording. Oh yeah, finish. Copy. Paste. Copy. Paste. Now we can go to the graphical interface of our new local NAS. OpenMediaVault. Oh yeah. You can simply use your server IP address. The same one used to connect to the SSH. And the username is admin and password is OpenMediaVault. Okay, I change the language. To English. And of course the first thing you should do is change your password. Okay. Now we can go to storage, disks. Okay, here you should see your connected disks. If you need more details, the view can be easily customized. Okay, now we can go to file system. And mount an existing file system. I choose my hard drive. Save. And apply. You need to save all changes and then apply. This is very important because otherwise the changes will not be applied. And this can take some time. Yep. Okay, ready. Now we can go to shared folders. Create. You can add some name, for example share. Choose your file system and save, and of course apply. Okay, now we can go to services and SMB settings, enable, and yeah, save. And of course, apply. Okay. Now shards. Create. Choose your share folder. Share. Here you can allow guest access without password, but I don't recommend this. So no. Yeah, it's safe. Apply. Yes. Okay. And yeah, that's all for now. Okay, this is probably the easiest way to share files. As you can see, there are a lot of options, but on the beginning I recommend doing just this to check if everything works. Then we can add more changes in the configuration. Okay, now let's go to users. User. Okay, now I will add access from our user and his group to my network drive. Share folders permission. Read write, save, apply. Yes. And groups, Raspberry. Okay. Also read write, save. Apply. Yes. Now it's worth checking if you have access to the shared network drive. You can just open this PC, click right, add network location, next, choose a custom network location, next, enter your server IP. And name of your share folder. Next. I will use the login and password when I'm creating the image for my Raspberry. Of course, you can change this password in OpenMediaVault or create more users. Okay, remember my credentials. Next. Perfect. Finish. Okay, as you can see, I have access to my share folder. You can create here a new folder or add wherever I want. The best thing is that you can now add this network folder in the same way on other computers in your local network and have access to the same folder there too. Awesome. Oh, and one more thing. When you install OpenMediaVault, you will probably lose SSH access to your server. To get it back, go to the users, choose your user, edit, groups, and choose SSH. Save. Of course, apply, and yes. Yep, that's all. Now you should have SSH access to your server again. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. Don't miss new episode and subscribe to the channel. And if you are looking for more tutorials, visit my blog. See you in the next video. Bye.